we are start with the introduction of user defined function, where we are using that concept. So suppose I make one program using thousands of lines, then what happens when we want to find some error in that particular program, then it makes very difficult. So to overcome this type of problems, now what we can do, we can divide that whole program in a number of parts, and that parts we can say that our module or our user defined functions. So the definition is just like, it is a self contained block of code that performs some specific task. Specific task means, suppose it perform addition, or it performs subtraction or factorial and many more. Clear? So the user defined function mainly use when suppose you have a program like scientific calculations, then there are some number of modules we can develop, like addition, sine, cos, then square root. So that different logic we can put in a different part, that we can say that self-contained block. Clear? And that is our functions. So there are mainly two types of functions. First is a inbuilt function and second is a user defined functions. And about inbuilt functions, we are already discussed in our previous module, that is string. So strlen, strcpy, strcat, these all are the inbuilt functions. In which header file it is used? It is used in a string.h. So likewise, that there are so many inbuilt functions that we have to directly call in our program. But suppose some functions are not available, then also it can be created by a user using the second types, that is user defined function. That is our chapter that we have to learn how we can create it. So the benefits of using this user defined function is, first, we can divide the large problem into the number of parts, small different parts, and that part we can easily maintain, easily debug and understand. Using that different parts, we can easily find the errors. Also, we can write the code easily. So our complexity of program becomes less. Now the next benefits, it what? It is reusable code, means the logic of our user defined function can be used in any other program also. So these all are the benefits. Now move to the elements of a user defined function and why we require it. So if you remember, in our previous practical session, we are writing all the logics in a void main functions. But now when you are creating its own function, user creates its own function, then we need three different elements. The first is a function declaration, second is a function definition, and third is a function call. Using these three elements, we can create user defined function. So the start with first, function declarations. When we are using declaration, suppose we want to store any values in a variable, then that variable we have to declare first in our declaration part. Clear? But now we are creating our own functions, so that particular function we have to compulsorily declare in our program. And the syntax for declaring function is simple. First we have to write return type, then function name, and inside round bracket we have to write the parameters. And here the parameters are optional, that depends on our next theory, that is category of function, and last is a semicolon. So the return type is nothing but we can say that data type, like integer, character, float, double, and void. So if we are writing in a return type void, the meaning is what? The function returns nothing. But suppose I am writing integer in a return type, the meaning is the function returns integer value. Clear? Let's see the example. The first example is void print line, and inside round bracket we are writing void, or also you can keep it blank. So the meaning is what? Here the return type is void, means the function name is print line, returns nothing, and there is a no parameters because void is there. Second is integer sum and then inside round bracket we are passing two parameters, integer a and integer b. What is the meaning of it? Now our function name is sum that returns integer value, and that value is depends on a two parameters a and b. So the answer of a and b, addition of a and b will be of type integer. That's why here return type is integer. Clear? Likewise that you can write any function declaration. Now move to the second, that is function definition. The definition means now user have to create function, and for that we have to follow the syntax like return type, then function name, and inside round bracket parameters are there. Then after in a curly bracket start and stop we have to write the logic, and the first is always declaration part. Local variables we are writing here because the variables which are inside this curly bracket we can say that it is local, and if the variables are outside of this bracket then it is known as global. So for a global and local variable we will see in details in our next video. Then the executable part is there, and after that the third statement is return. So here if the return type is void, that indicates what? There is a no return statement. But suppose the return type is integer, then we have to compulsorily write the third statement, that is return statements. Now understand with an example. So this definition part just like our void main. So void main is again function, but it is of kind inbuilt. Inside void main we are writing declaration and executable. So same concept here, but now the logic is changed. Now it is not an inbuilt function, but it is created by user. So in an example here I am writing void, indicate the function returns nothing. Then function name. Function name means user can write anything like as a variable name, and that depends on a user and depends on a logic. Suppose my function is regarding addition, then you can write name add some like. Suppose my function is regarding factorial, then we can write the name fact factorial. That depends on a user. And then third is a parameters. Here the parameters are nothing, that's why we are writing void. And then inside curly brackets only the one statement is there, that is printf. Inside curly bracket we are writing double inverted my name is Bhumi. Then what happened? Only the printf statement will be executed and the answer is my name is Bhumi. So this is nothing but the user defined functions. All the logic of our functions we have to write in it. Clear? And now move to the third one, that is function call. So if you remember the theory structure of C program that is discussed in our second unit, fundamentals of C, then the user defined function is there after the void main. Clear? So after void main we have to write the function definition, but we can say like that our program execution it start with a void main starting bracket and complete at a curly bracket closing. So how the user defined function can execute, for that we have to use this concept third element, that is function call. So the syntax for a function call is simple. We have to write the function name and inside bracket we have to pass the parameters and then semicolon. What happen when we are writing function call in a void main, then the function is called and the definition part will be executed. But suppose you are missing this function call in your program, then that particular function cannot be executed even if it is written after the void main. Clear? So this is very most elements that we have to remember. And the example here is first print line, that is function name, and then empty bracket that indicates there is a no parameter. Second example is sum, and inside bracket just we have to pass the variable name. Here I am passing two variables a and b. Instead of variable also you can pass the constant value, that is in a third example sum, then 10, 20. So as per your need you can write any of the function call. Now, using these three elements, we can create our own functions. How? Let's understand with very simple example to print welcome two time. Clear? So, first always we have to write the header file, that is has include stdio.h, and after that we are writing what? Void main in each and every program right now. But now our concept is changed and we have to apply user defined function, and for that the first element is function declaration, that is always before void main. If you remember the structure of C program theory, then before void main the section is there, that is global variable declarations. In that section we can declare the global variables, also we can declare the user defined functions. So always you have to remember the function declaration is before void main. So here I am writing void, then function name print line and empty bracket, or you can write void also. Now after it we have to write void main, and inside void main we have to write function call, then and then our functions will be executed. Clear? So the function name is print line and bracket, that is what? Function call. Here the function call is two times. Now after completing void main, our function definition will start, and function definition is just like same as declaration, that is void print line, and inside bracket we have to write void, and start the function with a curly bracket and stop with a ending bracket. Clear? And inside these two bracket we have to write declaration part, executable part and return statements. But here only we have to print welcome. So only one statement is there, that is printf welcome slash n. Clear? So how this program will execute? Our program execution start with void main opening brackets and stop at a closing brackets. So it start with a function call first print line. When this function is call, it is similar to our phone call, so it connect with that particular function. So it just find the print line function in your whole program and jump onto that part. So here the print line function is after void main, so cursor is move onto that particular function definition, and then the printf statement is executed, means our output is generated, that is welcome. Now cursor is come back onto the void main and it execute second time function call. So again it calls to the second time function print line and print the same message welcome. Clear? And come back. Suppose I am writing function call third time print line again, then what happen? Cursor move onto that functions again. Clear? So as per your requirement, as per your logic, you can call function any times. Clear? So here the output of this program is two time welcome. Clear? So this concept you have to use whenever you are writing any of the program using user defined function. I hope you guys understand this concept very well. If you like this video, then thumbs up. If you think this video will help some of your friends, then do share this video with them. Also, you can subscribe my channel, so when I upload new video, you get a notifications. Now, in our next lectures, we will discuss more about the functions.